I'm Tom Santi. I play tight end and wide receiver for the Virginia Cavaliers. One day I hope to play for the Tennessee Titans because I'm a hometown hero.
Some guys make fun of, you know, the way I talk sometimes. Sometimes I slip into a little bit of, you know, a little thicker country accent, but no, that's just who I am. That's where I come from. It's all good-natured ribbing, so I take it as it is.
God, he's got country in him. When he first came here, his hair was, I think, down to here, down past, you know, his shoulders. But he got that cut off real quick. But, he's from Nashville. He loves his music.
It's hard to come from Nashville and not listen to a little country music. You might catch me singing every once in a while. Sometimes I'll get my hand on the iPod and put on a good country song. For the most part, though, it's not too much country.
I think Tom, as much as people bust his chops about stuff, people really respect Tom. He's one of the more respected guys on the team.
When I was looking at where I wanted to go, I wanted to go to a good combination of, you know, good athletics and good academics, and this was just a good fit.
Tom's got the brains, he's one of those guys, you know, he went to a private school, an all-boys school in Tennessee, and, you know, he took his grades real, real seriously, and he's kind of the brains of the group. Whenever we don't know a word or something, he kind of shouts it out, you know, Mr. SAT guy, 14-something on his SATs. We jag him sometimes, but it's all good fun.
Some guys kind of joke with me if I use a big word or something like that, but, you know, I mean, we got a lot of smart guys on the team.
Some people call him Doc, you know, because he's just so, you know, wise beyond his years. And I personally, you know, haven't lived with Tom before, and just being so tight with Tom, just you marvel at the way he goes about his day. He's that type of guy that, you know, he'll read the Wall Street Journal in the morning and all that stuff. He's a sophisticated dude.
I view academics in the same kind of perspective that I view athletics, just that if it's something that I'm doing, I want to be good at it. It's like the academic Heisman. That's what a lot of people bill it as. You know, you got to be, you know, a good student to do it. I think you have to have a certain GPA, like a 3.2 or 3.3 GPA, and also be competitive on the field. You know, I don't want to just slide by. And I just kind of attack it the same way. Try to be as efficient and effective as I can.
The lone running back for Higgins. Five-step drop and stays in a pocket. Looks over the middle. Man wide open. Santi, 40, 35, 30, 25 to the middle of the field.
If I think about the Music City Bowl, it always has, you know, a good feeling attached to it. You know, we're in Nashville. Got to play in the Titans Stadium and had a lot of friends and family there. And we were able to come back from 14 points down early in the game and to win a game there.
He willed us to victory. We needed an offensive spark because early on the defense was having trouble. And Tom, we hit him on the seam 3 or 4 times. He just willed us to victory. And, you know, being his hometown, you know, there was like the Tom Santi cheering section. I saw signs. I saw, you know, I think there might have been an airplane flying overhead with a little message on the tail. Go number 86. Everybody loves Tom back there. You can really tell. But I think that's a testament to the type of guy he is. He's personable, he's hardworking, and he's tough, and he really embodies a real good football player.
When he's on the field, he's a leader, and it's hard to find guys like that will, when they're on the field and off the field, be one of those guys that you can come to and talk to, that knows what's going on, who's been in the system for a while. And he's just one of those guys that everyone really looks up to and respects and knows that Tom's gone through it all. You know, he's had ups and he's had downs, and he's one of the guys that everyone looks up to. And I think that it's really important that a leader be someone that you look up to and that you respect and that you know has gone through the tough times and the good times.
You know, I've been in a lot of positions, so I've been in those guys' shoes. You know, it's not just, a guy from an outside position talking to you. You know, I've been there. I've played that same role. And so it's easy, you know, for me to communicate with some guys. If it's something that I've seen there in that position, and I can help them to see it. I'm definitely a different person now than I was when I first walked on the campus here. I think a lot of that is just being around the people that I've been around getting to learn from some great people. It's been a real pleasure to be around a lot of people that I've had the chance to associate with here, and that's definitely helped me to shape the person that I am.